We are going to solve a problem. So this problem is one of the oldest problems in mathematics. And this problem was given by a scientist called Fibonacci. Can anyone draw a link if I say he was a mathematician from medieval times from the country of Italy? What could it possibly mean? Which period did he probably belong to, Piram?
13th century.
Why do you think he is from 13th century?
Because in 13th century in Italy, a Renaissance period had occurred, and in that lot of literature and science, mathematicians has increased.
Okay, very good.
He said that in nature, what happens is, there is a pair of rabbits. Let's call them male M1 and F1. So these pair of rabbits, when they come together, they can reproduce only at the end of second month. And after the second month, what will happen is, for every month, this new pair will keep reproducing babies. Okay? So what you have to find, and what Fibonacci asked, is can you find at the end of 6 months, at end of 1 year, how many pairs of rabbits will be there? Try to name the rabbits, otherwise you will get confused.
Bye. In the third month, M1 and F1 did, and then fourth one also then.
So fourth month, M1, F1 will be there.
Yes, well, and it will also produce one.
It will produce another one. Let's call it M4, F4.
Yes, and M2 and F2 will also produce. M2, they will be there.
M2, F2 will be there, and they will produce another one.
Yes.
Let's call it M5, F5. Who
and
else will be there?
M3, F3 will be there.
M3 and F3 produce?
No.
Why?
Because they are not that much matured.
Yes, they have not achieved the maturity. It is still their first phase. Look at this group of numbers and take 30 seconds individually, and then you will tell me if anyone is able to find a certain pattern in this series of numbers. And without calculating the rabbits, can you tell me the next 3 digits which will come in this series?
I see that from first month there are one, and after second month there are also one, and after third month there are two, because I see that first and second added and there is two, and after that month there is third, and there also after second and third month that added to and that get three.
So in the seventh month we will have 13 pair of rabbits.
21.
Who will tell me the next?
Me.
Rohit.
34.
Next. Piram. Soil.
45.
45, is he right?
No.
55. Right? And this series will go on and on and on together. So the mathematical term that we use is called a sequence. So based on this example, the same set of numbers, can anyone probably arrive at a definition of a sequence?
A formula by adding or dividing or anything, we get the second number, and it is repeating again, again and again, it will call sequence.
What is being repeated, beta?
Number?
No, numbers are not being repeated, no, there is something else that is being repeated. You are correct, you are saying you are on the right track, I am just looking for one keyword. Yes, correct. Pattern. Very good. Sequence is a series of numbers with repeating patterns. Using sequence and using this Fibonacci series, let us try to understand what is the meaning of ratio and proportion. Abed and Sohel are going to tell me 13 and 8 equal to kitna aata hai. Aman and Rohit, you are going to divide 21 by 13. Ayush and Arjun, you are going to divide 34 by 21. And Shubham, Piram and Yash, you are going to divide 55 by 34. Quickly, beta, 10 seconds. When we are taking any two numbers, consecutive numbers, and we are dividing a next number by a previous number, we are getting 1.6. So what is 13 by 8, 21 by 13, 34 by 21? These are all ratios. Ratio is division of one quantity by another.
Then it can be said that fraction is a ratio.
So, Aman is asking, can fraction be called a ratio? What is the difference between a fraction and ratio? But a fraction is when you are just taking two numbers and representing it as numerator, as denominator. So yes, every fraction is a ratio, but not all ratios are fractions. So what happens to a ratio in a sequence?
It will divide the
That's okay, just one word. What will happen to a ratio in a sequence?
Pattern will change.
Well, the ratio will be always same in
Exactly, case. Ratio will always be same. This ratio of two numbers in a Fibonacci series, this ratio of 1.618 is something which is also known as golden ratio in mathematics. Now the question is, why golden ratio? Why will we call it a golden ratio? Think of your ancient history lectures, 6th standard, right? So which period in Indian history was referred to as golden period?
Gupta's period was known as golden history because in that lot of changes and development happened in India.
So when I am saying you have a golden opportunity or it is a golden period, it means it is a unique opportunity. And what is the meaning of unique? Unique comes from which word? What is the root? What is the meaning of unique? Ayush?
Very different.
Very different? Aman?
Different from other.
Different from others. Abhay, do you want to add?
Yeah. Different from others, and that is just one opportunity.
So unique comes from uni, which in Latin means one. So now we'll do an activity which you are going to do in pairs. So when I give you an object, you are going to measure it, and the other person will record and calculate. This ratio is called a golden ratio because it is there all around us. In almost most of the objects that we see around, this ratio and this series of Fibonacci series is being repeated. Group number 1 gets 2 pieces of lemon. Common nimbu, slices of lemon. First, you will tell me how many sections of slices are there in a slice of lemon. How many sections are there? Sections, samajh rahe ho?
Yes.
How many coordinates? How many quadrants are there? What is the length of this side of a slice? Abed, focus here first. Yeah. And what is the length of this side?
It's 1.7. So, let's put it down. Where is the scale? Start from the center to the end. Okay?
Start from center.
Center, no, obviously. What is it that you're getting?
1.9. Shubham and Piram's group, switchboard. What was the length of a switchboard? 24. And what was the breadth?
14.8.
So when you divide, what do you get?
1.62.
Okay. Why is it called a golden ratio? Because most of the rectangular objects that you see around, they follow this ratio. Abhi, right now what will happen is because there are instrumental errors, all these scales and these strips are not perfect. So when you approximate, most of them approach towards this value of 1.618.
We have only most of the rectangles, not all.
Not all. But when you talk about nature, think about flowers. So you take any flower, if you try to calculate the petals of a flower, the petals will either be 5, either be 8, either be 3, either be 13. It is said that for an average adult, the ratio between your navel is that point in your stomach, to the floor, with the distance from navel to the head of the or the top of your head, will actually come around 1.61. We can do this in the break and also find out. So each group has to pick one topic or usse related, we'll discuss the application of golden ratio. Okay? Field 1 is art and architecture. Field 2 is nature and universe. Field 3 is technology and companies, right? Companies. And field 4 is acting. So Abed's group, what are you going to pick?
Companies and technology.
So you all know that when companies, they go commercial, they have to design their logos. So if you see Pepsi is essentially two concentric circles. So what Abed and Sohel are going to today find out is, they will first find out this distance, which is the diameter of the outer circle of Pepsi's logo. And then they are going to find B, which is the diameter of the inner concentric circle within the logo. And then you are going to find out what is the ratio between the outer circle and inner circle. This monument is in Greece. And this monument is known as Parthenon. What is it called?
Parthenon.
So, ye jo Parthenon ka actually construction kiya gaya tha, that construction was also done based on those golden proportion. And same for Mona Lisa. So, Rohit and Aman are going to investigate whether golden ratio is being followed in the proportion of Parthenon and proportion of Mona Lisa as well.
Yes, Aman. And we also take it out for square.
For a square. Okay, we will do. Hold that question.
Iska karega? Shell? Yes, you will do for star. Measure ABCD.
I will do for the hand.
You will do for the hand.
Why is this ratio being used? Ye 1.618 ka hi ratio se banane ka kya zarurat?
Why I think it's not, matlab ki jab they are making it, they have not taken that it will came 1.
So you're saying it's a coincidence that so many things
yeah,
around us?
Yeah, it can't coincidence, no, because he has not
exact ratio. But is it a coincidence?
If someone is asking that what is the length of this, so we can't directly go measure, so we can tell it is approximately near 1.618.
So Abel is saying that probably it is just a coincidence. Okay, let us hold that for a thought. So Aman is, Shubham is saying because it will be easier to measure things. Try to think of a very simpler basic answer.
Apart from the things accurate.
Accurate?
And proper and beautiful.
Beautiful, perfect. To make things look more beautiful. So mathematically, 1.618 is a constant which is denoted by this symbol and it is known as phi. What is it known as?
Phi.
Phi. And using phi, how do we construct a golden rectangle? Name any Fibonacci number up after 3. Cell
8.
Okay. I'll draw a rectangle using 13 and 8 as my dimensions. Centire was 13, this is 8. Iska length kitna aega?
5.
What will be this?
8.
This will be 8, this will be 8. So this I am getting as a square. Correct? This I am getting as a rectangle. Ye rectangle ka length kitna hai?
8.
Breadth kitna hai?
5.
So 8 and 5 is again Fibonacci number. So a golden rectangle is a rectangle whose length and width have a ratio of 1.618. And when you divide that rectangle into a square and a rectangle, you again get a golden rectangle whose dimensions will correspond to Fibonacci numbers. So now we'll quickly recap what did we do in today's lecture. So today's lecture is over. Before I give you the assignments, can anyone form a link between this concept of golden ratio proportion and link it to what we did in the morning meeting today when we were discussing about balance?